Good day to everyone. So our topic for today is about what we call polygraph technique. So in the polygraph examination, is we say that generally used an investigative aid or a technical aid in the investigative process, yung polygraph examination. So the polygraph examination is used to verify if the statement of the victims or a complainant, and it also used to establish the credibility of the witnesses and evaluates the truthfulness of the suspects. So aside from that, the polygraph examination is also used for pre-employment screening and the loyalty check of personnel, and also the security risk such as the leakage of information and the counterintelligence, infraction of the criminal law, misconduct, and the use in the medical measurement. But in law enforcement, polygraph examination is significant because it is considered as one among the most effective way of establishing the truth. Okay, so through it, guilt can be established and is scientifically accepted, where the investigator can evaluate the evidence. So what is the ultimate objective of conducting polygraph examination? So the ultimate objective of a polygraph examination is to obtain the subject's admission or confession to the offense committed. So when we say admission, the statement of fact by the accused in which do not directly involve acknowledgement of guilt in committing or having participated in the commission of an offense. While the confession, it is a declaration. Okay, yung pag-amin made by the person voluntarily stating or acknowledging that he has committed or participated in the commission of a crime. So this is the ultimate objective of conducting polygraph examination. Okay. So next is the tripod foundation of polygraph technique. So the tripod foundation of polygraph technique, there are three. We have the basical, we have the mechanical basic premise, the physiological, and the psychological basic premise. So when we say mechanical basic premise, the polygraph machine is mechanically capable of making graphical records containing reliable information regarding physiological changes. Okay. So while the physiological in the physiological basic premise, among the physiological changes that may be recorded and identified are those that automatically occur only following the stimulation of specific nervous system. Okay, specific nervous system component, and from which stimulation of those specific nervous system components can be reliably diagnosed. So what are these physiological changes, like the respiration, the heartbeat, and also the electrodermal activity, yung sweating natin, and also the psychological basic premise. Under the polygraph leg premise, the specific nervous system component whose stimulation can thus be diagnosed are so stimulated by the involuntary mental and emotional processes of the individual. Okay, who is consciously attempting concealment of deception, especially if that individual has something at stake and the prevailing circumstances lead him to believe that exposure of detection is quite possible through though undesirable. It is psychological basic premise. It involves the emotion, the mental and emotional processes. Okay. So, what are the physiological phenomena as the basis of detecting deception as per the Trifold Foundation? First is we have the blood pressure and heart beat frequency. So, increase of the blood pressure and heartbeat frequency following relevant question and the suppression in breathing are the criteria of detecting deception. Okay. So the ink curves as shown on the heartbeat recorded on a moving graph paper of the polygraph represent the beat frequency or the pulse and the two pressure or yung blood pressure natin. Because we have two pressures, we have the systolic or the high pressure and the diastolic or the low pressure. When we say systolic, they exist when the heart is contracted on the valves and the valves are open with the blood rushing into the arteries, while the diastolic is exists when the valves are closed and the heart relax. Okay, so the heart, yung puso natin, is an automatic organ that continues to beat when even when removed from the body as provided with basta meron siyang proper blood. Okay, so the rate force of the heartbeat as regulated by two sets of nerve. What are these two set of nerves? We have the sympathetic set and the cranial autonomic system. Okay. When we say sympathetic, it accelerate the beat of our heart, and the cranial autonomic, okay, it retards the beat. Okay, so take note that the new, the normal blood pressure is 120 over 80. Okay. So another one is the breathing as a means of detecting deception. So in breathing, it consists of two steps. We have the inspiration and the expiration. When you say inspiration, it is caused by the contraction of the diaphragm and the expansion of the chest cavity. Those result in the air rushing into the lungs. Okay. And ito yung inhale na tinatawag natin. While the expiration, okay, it is caused by the relaxation of the diaphragm and the contraction of the chest cavity, resulting in the air rushing out to the lungs. Yung palalabasin mo yung hangin dyan sa loob. Okay. So, what are the... these are the... following okay, that may affect the breathing. Okay, the following affects the breathing rates. We have the muscular exercise and also the anticipation. These are only example, and the anticipation of muscular exercise, yung iniisip mo pa lang na ikaw ay magtatrabaho, it will affect your breathing. Okay, recalling mental emotional experience, mental activity, anxious expectancy, shock and surprise. Okay, this may affects the breathing rates. Okay, another one is the electrodermal response. This is the most current popular name for the human body phenomenon in which the body, mainly the skin, changes resistance electrically upon the application of certain stimuli. So the electrodermal response, it consists of two categories. We have the normal response and we have the abnormal response. So there are examples of abnormal responses. We have the machine fright response or the feeling of fear sa instrument na yan. We have the physical movement response. Okay. Interfering response caused by voluntary physical movement by the subject during the lie test. Because the result of such physical movement causes physiological or muscle changes to take place within the body that shows up electrodermal response. And the outside interference response, interfering response of the originating of the reaction chain in the form of unwanted auditory or stimuli. Kagaya ng slamming of the door or the ringing of telephone. Yeah. Yan yung mga example ng outside interference response. A cough or sneeze by spectators in the room or any unusual noise to which the subject is not accustomed at the location will usually produce outside interference response. While mental type response, interfering response which originates between the machine fright and the emotion in the reaction chain. So the other name of the mental tie-up response is the guilt complex. Okay. And the other one is the deception response. These are the abnormalities as a result of telling a lie, more on psychological and also is accompanied by physical changes. Okay. So there is a question. Maraming nagtatanong, is the polygraph technique accurate? Okay. So there are current polygraph research, okay, that indicates when a specific single issue of polygraph examination conducted by a qualified and competent polygraph examiner and is properly administered, the accuracy rate is between 95% to 98%. Okay. So this percentage is still higher than other forms of evidence, including the psychiatric opinions, suspect identification as provided by the victims and the witnesses. Okay. So the polygraph is the most accurate tool available today for determining truth or deception. So the accuracy of the multi-issue exam drops in accuracy due to the number of psychological factors. So these statistics do not include inconclusive test result in which no opinion of truth or deception can be made from the physiological data collected on the polygraph chart. And the technique itself and the result of the polygraph examination has been source of unending question. Okay. However, practitioners have agreed that the accuracy of the polygraph results is high depending upon the factors that affect it. Okay. Depende kasi yan sa mga factors na nakaka-apekto. Okay. So what are those factors? The instrument, the condition of the subject, the condition of the examination room, and the qualification and skills of the examiner. Okay. So, what are the errors of lie detection test? So, the errors of lie detection test come from the following circumstances. First is the nervousness or extreme emotional tension experienced by the subject who is telling the truth. Okay. Regarding the offense in question, but who is nevertheless affected by the, for example, other anxiety to operate in order to assure an accurate test. Okay. Anger, resentment, over having to take a lie detector test. Previous extensive interrogation, especially when accompanied by physical abuse. Okay. Another one is the physiological abnormalities. Okay. Alam mo yung mga physiological abnormalities na yan. Okay. Na nagiging error of lie detection test. Okay. Hindi mo chinek yung subject mo is meron pala siyang sakit sa puso. Meron siyang respiratory disorder. Okay. Excessively high or excessively low blood pressure. Tapos in-examine mo siya through polygraph examination. Error na yan sa polygraph examination. Okay. Mental abnormalities. Yung mga psychosis, psychotic, yung mga idiots, okay, imbeciles, morons, okay, yung mga manic depressive, paranoid, schizophrenic, yan, kasali yan sa mental abnormalities. Okay, nakapag in-examine mo na may ganyang kalagayan ng subject, magiging probably lang siya sa error of lie detection test. Unresponsiveness in lying or guilty subject. Okay. Bakit unresponsive? Okay. Because maybe wala siyang takot for detection, no fear of detection, or apparent inability to consciously control response by means of certain mental set of attitudes. Yan. A condition of subshock or adrenal exhaustion at the time of test. And also kabilang yan, bakit unresponsive yung subject is because of the extensive interrogation prior to the test. Okay. And also attempt to beat the machine. Okay. Kung minsan kasi yung mga subject is kinokontrol nila yung kanilang paghinga or gumagalaw by means of muscular flexing. Okay. And the unobserved application of muscular pressure which produces ambiguities and misleading indications in the blood pressure tracing. Okay. So these are the errors of lie detection. Another one. Okay. What are the limitations of the polygraph technique? So first, it is an invaluable investigative aid but never a substitute for investigation. Hindi mo siya pwedeng gamitin substitute for investigation. It is not a lie detector but a scientific diagnostic instrument. It does not determine facts. It records responses to which the subject is known to be true, okay, and is also accurate as the examiner is competent. Masasabi mo lang na accurate yan kapag competent yung forensic psychophysiologist na yan or the polygraph examiner. The test will not be given until enough facts have been established to permit the examiner to prepare a complete set of suitable questions. Dapat kompleto yung may bigay na information dun sa polygraph examiner para makagawa ng magandang katanungan. The test will not be given without voluntary consent of the subject. Hindi may bibigay yung polygraph examination kung ayaw ng subject. Okay, dapat voluntary. Okay, no indication will be given to any person or place in any report that the person will be considered guilty because he refused to take the test. Di mo pwedeng sabihin na guilty yung subject kasi ayaw niyang mag-undergo ng polygraph examination test. A test will not be given until the accusation have been explained with the subject. Dapat na-explain muna sa subject mo. Ano ba yun? Bakit andun siya? Okay. And no attempt to use polygraph for mental or physical evaluation of any person. Hindi mo pwedeng gamitin na yung polygraph test na yan para alamin yung mental or physical condition ng isang tao. And no examination will be conducted on unfit subject. Okay. So what are the barriers of polygraph examination? So there are instances where it is possible to make an analysis of polygraph test because of the following. Okay? First is pathological liar. When we say pathological liar, a person who cannot determine the right and wrong. Okay? Mental cases. persons under the influence of intoxicating liquor, narcotics-related cases, and the various heart and other organic troubles. So these are the barriers to the polygraph examination. Okay. So, dito na tayo. Paano ba magtatrabaho yung polygraph instrument na yan? So, in the polygraph examination, okay, so the polygraph simultaneously records various physiological phenomena by means of horizontal chemograph. Okay. The resulting polygraph indicates tracings of external respiration in the thoracic. Ito na yung mga pneumograph natin. Pneumograph 1. And the abdominal cavities, yung pneumograph 2, by means of pneumograph tambour assembly. Okay. The systolic and the diastolic contraction of the heart, as well as the pulse fluctuations with the resistance of sphygmomanometer and the psychogalvanic skin response by means of finger electrodes to the fingers of the subject. Okay. Each phenomenon is recorded by a hollow tube, ink stylus moving across horizontally and vertically rolled, being driven by a synchronous electronic motor. Okay. Ganyan magtrabaho yung polygraph instrument. Okay. So the physiological changes within the examiner's body are monitored by the following attachment. What are these attachments? Ano yung kanilang mga nire-record? Okay, unang-una yung respiratory rate. Okay, the yung respiratory rate natin, ang nag-monitor niyan is the pneumograph 1 and pneumograph 2. The two rubber tubes, okay, filled with air, called the pneumographs, are placed around the examinee's chest and abdomen. Okay, when the chest or abdominal muscles expand, the air inside the tube is displaced. So the digital or computerized polygraph employs transducers to convert the energy of the displaced air into electronic signal. Okay. Next is the blood pressure rate. Okay, or the heart rate. So a blood pressure cuff is placed around the examinee's upper arm. Tubing runs to from the cuff of the polygraph. Again, in digital or computerized polygraphs, these signals are converted into electrical signals by transducers. Okay. So yung blood pressure cuff natin is inirarap yan sa left upper arm, okay, through brachial artery, okay, para makuha yung blood pressure. Okay, and also the galvanic skin resistance, or it is called also called the electrodermal activity, and is basically a measure of sweat on the subject fingertips. Okay. Bakit sa fingertips? Because the fingertips are one of the most porous, maraming butas, most porous areas on the body, and therefore are good place to look for sweat. Okay. The jury is we sweat more when we are placed under stress. Kapag stress tap tayo, is doon nagkakaroon tayo ng pinapawisan tayo masyado. So finger electrodes are attached of two of the examinee's fingers. So these electrodes measures the skin ability to conduct electricity. So when the skin is hydrated, as with the sweat, it conducts electricity much more easily when it is dry. So ang sinusunod kasi sa pag-attach ng mga sensor na yan is first is the pneumograph. It is being placed on the thoracic or chest part of the subject. Okay, the second is the pneumograph 2, which is being placed on the abdominal part or abdominal cavity of the subject. And after that is the blood pressure cuff. It is being wrapped around the left arm or bicep through the brachial artery of the subject to monitor the blood pressure. And the last one is the finger electrodes is attached or being placed at the index and ring finger of the subject. Okay. Bakit may pagitan? Kasi may kuryente nga. May ground. So it is on the index and the ring finger. So after the test, kung ano yung huling inilagay, yun ang unang tatanggalin. Okay? Tatanggalin mo yung finger electrodes, then the blood pressure cuff, the pneumograph 2, and the pneumograph 1. Okay? So ito yung makabagong polygraph instrument. Kompleto siya. Yung chair niya pwedeng makapag-detect ng physical activity. Yan. Meron din siyang ito kasi ay computerized. Ito yung mga channel ng mga instrument natin. Okay? So, the major components of polygraph instrument. Okay? So, the pneumograph component, it records the breathing and the respiration. This component occupies the two upper pens of the instrument, which records the thoracic and abdominal breathing patterns of respiration. So it consists of the two hollow corrugated tube about 10 inches length, 10 inches yun ang haba ng pneumograph 1 and pneumograph 2 tube. Okay, it's attached to a unit by a rubber hose not longer than 6 feet. Okay, and not larger than 1/4 inch in diameter. Okay. So another one is the cardiograph component. It records the blood pressure. Okay, it composed of or this is the fourth pen. Okay, yung pang-apat, yung pinaka-baba. Okay, of the or the bottom pen of the instrument. So this cardio unit is mechanically operated unit. It is a high pressure system. So this system records the changes in the mean blood pressure rate and the strength of the pulse beat by means of a medical blood pressure cuff containing a rubber bladder that is wrapped around the upper arm. Okay. In a manner that places the bladder against the brachial artery. So the bladder is connected to the rubber hose past a pressure indicating gauge to very sensitive bellows, and it's connected the lever system that powers the pen. Okay. So the blood pressure cuff is placed around the subject's upper arm. Okay, the tubing runs from the cuff to the polygraph. As blood pumps through the arm, it makes sound. So the changes in pressure caused by the sound displace the air in the tubes, which are connected to the bellows, which moves the pen. And also, wait lang. Okay, so next is the galvanograph component. Okay, so the galvanograph component, it records the skin resistance. Okay, it composed of the two finger electrodes, and these two finger electrodes is being attached to the index and ring finger of either left or right, but preferably in the right hand. This assembly will record the skin resistance of the subject with little amount of electricity, and it is also the longest and third pen of the instrument. Okay, 7 inches ang haba niyan, yung stylus pen ng galvanograph component. Okay, and also the chemograph component. Okay, this is the chart drive recording unit of the instrument. It has a synchronized motor that drives the chart at the rate of 6 to 12 inches per minute, and its speed constant is vital because the vertical lines, which are spaced either at 1/2 of an inch interval, represent 5 or 10 seconds interval on the chart. Okay. So this provides the polygraphist with a means of determining pulse rate and questioning space. So yung vertical lines ng polygraph chart, it composed of 5 seconds interval. Okay, so what are the factors that affects the accuracy of polygraph result? Ito na yung mga nakaka-apekto sa polygraph result natin. We have the instrument, the condition of the subject, the condition of the examination room, and the qualification and skills of the examiner. Dito kasi sa instrument, bakit nakaka-apekto sa polygraph test result yan? Okay. In polygraph examination, uses the polygraph instrument as the device used for recording the result. Okay. Hence, all its component and accessories must be operational and functional. Dapat functional and operational lahat ng parte ng polygraph instrument na yan para hindi maapektuhan yung polygraph result. Okay. How about the examiner? Okay. Based to all that has been said with regard to the utilization and accuracy of the polygraph technique is the matter of examiner qualifications and skills. Okay? So an examiner must be an intelligent person with reasonably good educational background, preferably college degree. Okay, and he should have an intense interest in the work itself. Interesado siya sa kanyang trabaho. And a good practical understanding of human nature and suitable personality traits, which may be evident from his otherwise general ability to get along with people and to be well-liked by his friends and associates. Sa polygraph examiner naman, or yung tinatawag nating forensic psychophysiologist, pa naman yun is no amount of training or experience will overcome lack of this necessary qualification. Okay? And also the subject. Generally, there are three types of subject for polygraph testing. We have the suspect, we have the victim or complainant, and we have the witnesses. So, what are the persons can be subjected for polygraph testing? Okay, sino-sino yung mga pwedeng mag-undergo ng polygraph testing? Okay, so the following can be subjected for polygraph testing. Subject whose guilt is definite or reasonably certain, emotional offender, person who commit crimes in the heat of passion, person whose offenses are accidental in nature, none of emotional offender, person who commit crimes for financial gain, and subject whose guilt is doubtful or uncertain. Ito yung mga po pwedeng mag-undergo ng polygraph test. Sino naman yung mga hindi pwede? Okay. Persons who have extreme nervousness. Yeah, hindi pwede yan. Okay. Person who have physiologically physiological abnormalities. Okay. Kagaya ng high blood. May sakit sa puso. May sakit sa ngipin. Yan. Kasali din yan. May sakit sa ulo. Okay. Or practically any painful ailments. Okay. Hindi pwedeng mag-undergo ng polygraph testing. Person with mental abnormalities, unresponsive person, pregnant women and persons below 18 years of age. Okay. These are the subjects who cannot be recommended to undergo polygraph testing. Okay. And the examination room. Okay. The examination room is importantly considered for an effective polygraph testing. So the condition of the room must be as follows. A lie detector should be conducted in a quiet private room, 90% soundproof. Okay, a room with none of the usual poorest surroundings with no distraction with the subject's view. Okay, hindi walang nakaka-distract sa paningin ng subject. A room without any windows at all to prevent outside interference response. Okay. Para walang masyadong marinig sa labas. The interrogation room should contain no ornaments, walang mga palamuti, walang mga picture na nakalagay na nakakadistract sa attention ng subject. A room free from noise such as ringing of a telephone and other conversation of persons outside the examination room. The presence of the other officers or the spectators in the room should be also avoided. Kasi ang nasa examination room lang is dalawa, yung subject and the polygraph examiner or the forensic psychophysiologist. Okay, adequate ventilation is needed with comfortable temperature. Okay, if a glass window is needed for this purpose, it should not be installed facing the subject and lightings should be not excessive. Okay. And also there should be an observation room adjacent to the examination room. Okay. A one-way mirror must be installed on the wall in between the rooms. Okay. So these are the factors that may affect the accuracy of polygraph testing. So what are the important reminders to the examiner? Okay. As an important reminder to the examiner, the following must be considered. First, do not wait until the last minute to ask a person to take the test. Tanungin muna siya kung gusto niya mag-undergo ng polygraph test or hindi. To tell the subject everything. Do not tell the subject everything that you know about the offense or about him. Huwag mo sabihin, alam mo lahat yung about sa kanyang kinasasangkot ang kaso. Do not fail to investigate the case before you ask a person to take the test. Okay. If for some reason it must be temporarily taken, the investigator must continue investigating the case. Do not depend on mass screening of possible suspect para lang alamin kung sino ba yung talagang totoo or the guilty subject. Okay. Do not tell anyone that the lie detector will decide whether one is innocent or guilty. Pag sabihin na yung polygraph machine is yung magde-decide. Okay. Only the court will make the decision. If the test indicates that the person did not tell the truth or if the person confesses after the test, do not think that the investigation is over. Kahit na may confession na doon sa polygraph test, patuloy pa rin yung investigation. Well, hindi mo masasabi, hindi doon nagtatapos yung investigasyon. Okay? So these are the important reminder to the examiner. Okay? So the usual duration of polygraph examination, it normally takes from 1 to 3 hours. The actual questioning aspect of the examination, okay, which may be repeated 3 to 4 times. and last no longer than a few minutes for each question. Okay. So limits may be set in some cases because the blood pressure cuff can be inflated for 10 to 12 minutes, causing the subject undue discomfort. Okay, so that's all. Thank you for listening, and thank you, and God bless.